Verde lighting up the court here. It's just so refreshing, so entertaining to see a world-class attacker against a world-class defender. Get really interestingly long rallies. There'll be a top 10 highlights of this match alone, I guarantee it.
One on.
But that is a low light for Sun Ying Sha. Misses the serve. Well, she sniffed the opportunity to attack there, Sekia Wan, but there was a lot of backspin and Sha Sha's push. She'll make that more times than she misses it, though, Sekia Wan, don't get me wrong. Wow. There you see how much she sizzles that one. She's got inverted rubber on her forehand side. She chops with it, as you see there, but if something loose comes, she will actually try to counter it. Similar to Han Ying of Germany in that respect.
3-2.
Sha Sha plays the ball into the wide forehand, though. Sekia Wan's not going to be able to chop it. She's going to have to basically either loop it or fish it onto the table, and then Sun's going to get a ball that she's a little bit more used to. Dismissive, isn't it? Such a strong base, a great transfer of weight, and she generates bucket loads of power there.
2-4.
On this winner. Look at that. Just a blur, isn't she? Made the mistake this time with the attack, but look at this. What you can do, I can do better, says Sun Ying Sha. Fades it right back at Sekia Wan. Past her, in fact. Poetry in motion. Looks like she's getting into a groove here, Sun. From the crowd, and look at that. That was a wounded forearm, wasn't it? Clipped the net. Sha Sha span it. And Sekia Wan blasts it. 5-3 here. Pendulum serve, well,
5-4.
The forehand flick beckoned, it was probably the right shot to take on, but Sun misses it. You've got to time it right at the peak of the bounce, that forehand flick. Easier said than done, though.
Lick, 5-4.
Oh, dribbler there. Oh, baby. Oh, she'll take it, sir. It's a beautiful serve that Sekia Wan has. As I say, really difficult to execute a high toss backhand serve. Can distract the opponent, but Sun Ying Sha is just keeping her eyes solely focused on the point of contact.
6-0.
She twiddles after she serves that to get the inverted rubber on the forehand ready for the attack. She can produce more spin with that side, and that's why she chooses it to serve with.
Seven,
gets her nose back in front here, Sun Ying Sha. This is her first match here. in singles. She had Dubai in the round of 64. Su Hyewon had to face Huang Yihua of Team Chinese Taipei and won it 3-1. She wins this. She'll have to face the big sister of Team Korea, Jun Ji-hee, who beat one of the Chinese youngsters, Xu Yi, pretty convincingly 3-0 earlier on in the day. Four South Koreans, in fact, in this half of the draw, which is crazy. But back to this, Sun Yingsha stamping her authority. Once the ball's high, Sun Yingsha's going to come through flat, and that makes it tougher for Su to chop.
9-7.
Ouch. Puts pressure on the attacker, knowing that if your push game isn't good enough, curtains. 62% win rate off a serve, Sun. Well, despite the effort, it's three game points here to the number one in the world, Sun Yingsha. Pendulum to forehand, right into the middle, straight out the table tennis textbook with her serves. Wow. Surprising serve. It's an identical service toss, different execution. So you've got to be really, really relaxed on the receive. Sun Yingsha having to adjust to a lot of different balls here.
Wow.
Look at the work of Sun Yingsha, the transition of her energy. She has a right leg behind the left leg, and then she comes through it forwards, as well as upwards with her arm to counteract that backspin. Exemplary play here against Chop.
One,
there,
two.
Makes the error. Drops about too much. This is another thing at the pro level. You can't show what you're going to do too soon, because your opponent then will make a change in their shot selection and you'll be stuck. It's all about controlled aggression, and that was a little bit wild from Sun. Looking to add to already so many titles that she's won, such as in Macau, Xinjiang and Ljubljana. As well as, of course, the World Championships, where she beat Chan Meng in the final, got her revenge from the Olympic Games in Tokyo. Right now, she's looking like she's going to be China's number one in Paris. So she'll be playing singles team and probably mixed doubles with Wang Chuqin, because they just won as well the Asian Games together. Almost unbeatable. Saying that though, they had a marathon match against Liang Jingquin and Chen Chenyi, so she must be a little bit fatigued, Sun Yingsha. Wow. Oh. Wow. How much does it take to break down this wall? Oh wow, she has chiseled that chop. Really short stroke that time. Shorter than normal from Su Hyewon. Goes to show it doesn't take a big one, just a fast one, an accelerated bit of racket speed. 5-3 up here, the Korean. That's not coming back.
5-4.
and the catch to match.
4-6.
So, she keeps the cushion of 2 points here, sir. Three of the four encounters, she's been beaten 4-0. Put that into perspective. Back in 2020, November it was, she lost 4-2, so Tuchson to six games at the ITTF finals, which was actually in China as well. Well, someone who doesn't know TT, that might look like an easy miss, but there was still a lot of backspin. So high though, after that one, that Sin felt obliged to whack it. Still not an easy ball to put away. Six of the last 8 points to Sir Hugh Won. She's throwing everything at her. We knew she'd have to. But to actually do it out here, something else. And she's got 6 game points. Dominant display there from the Korean. Well, the benefit of chopping into the middle of the defender, their body's in the way, so they can't make the full stroke on the chop. They're going to have to make a shorter stroke. Sun doing it straight away there on the third ball attack. Well, Sun there just basically opening the racket face and letting the rubber do the work, because it was so much backspin that came in, and that change of place, placement and speed rushed Sophia Wan into making it.
Love three.
More patient play here from Sun Ying Sha. Last 2 points she's won, she hasn't had to make an attack for the winner. Top edge is that one though. The initial chop of Sir can actually kind of kick up a little bit. Don't want to keep attacking into the backhand because it's going to get harder and harder to lift.
3-2.
Good change of serve there from the world number one. Fast serve into the crossover.
2-4.
It's not an easy point to win because you've got to actually be intelligent enough to recognise what you've done so far and go against that pattern. It takes maturity to do it. She's making it look easy, but it isn't. To put a marker pen there, that's where you'd want to draw it on the table. Pinpoint precision there with Sun fading it for the winner. Gorgeous stroke. Wow.
5-3.
That was a rocket chop. Came at Sun really quick. Low. That is brilliant. Versatility there. Sun puffing her cheeks out. That was really, really good. How has she made that?
6-3.
Well, despite the incredible reach of Sut, Sinjin Shah switches the direction of play there on the second one, stretches her a little bit too wide. You've got to have the peripheral vision as well as the ability to execute.
4-6.
Well, the net returns the serve before Sir has to. And it's 6-4. That is a early Christmas present. So slow, so spinny, and quite shallow. Look how high it comes off the blade when she chops it, and Sun, obviously a perfectionist, still not happy with the level she's bringing. She's made that look like taking candy off a baby. You can't really prepare for shots like that.
7-5.
That was one of the most casual forehands I've ever seen. Ooh.
7-6.
Sun is that good. It's tough to tell when she's actually being a bit over-optimistic. Cho Yika has called the timeout now because Sun is only 1 point away. Hammering blow.
6-8.
Good response after the timeout. Sinyin Shah looks remarkably calm despite the tension coming from the scoreboard pressure. So Hyewon has two serves. There's definitely a chance for it to level, but it's going to be tough. It is just spellbounding. Magical. Got any more adjectives? Because I'm going to run out probably this match. But Sinyin Shah just constantly changing the placement of the loops. Sometimes she intentionally puts a little bit less spin on it to give Sehyun less to work with on the chop.
9-7.
Sun is having to stay relaxed as well and not act too early because Sehyun is capable of chopping with side spin and it at the last second just kind of kicks. So can't come in a step around, for example, too soon. You've got to really watch what she's doing because she is crafty. Ooh.
9-8.
Well, it looked like the right shot, but Sehyun survives it and is so close, she's breathing down the neck of Sinyin Shah. Bit of fortune.
9-0.
Well, what a time to get it at 9-8. Now it really is anyone's. Sehyun has the serves and Sinyin Shah has looked a little bit nerve-wracked on the receive. Will Sehyun send it long or will she keep it sort of short to half long? We're going to see now. This is crunch time in the business end of this third game. Oh my God! Game point to Sergio Won. Can you imagine the Sha Sha fans in here? There'll be tears shed enough to fill the Yellow River. But she's missed a serve, can you believe it? She even smiles, Sun Ying Sha. She's got away with murder there. You've got to feel for Sun Ying Sha. That is heartbreaking. Game point to Sha Sha. So many twists in the tail of this third game. And now Sergio Won has her tail between her legs. She's facing game point. That is a brilliant push. She takes it basically off the bounce. Oh, this is heart-wrenching. But the gyros continue, of course they do, for Sha Sha. Has she got any more oil to add? Misses by a whisker, but Sha Sha again with the slow spin. A real recipe for success. Sergio Won's drifting further and further back, so to slow it down a bit, it's going to test her in and out footwork. Out to in, technically, that time. But a second game point to Sin. Oh my word! What a way to save it! A flat slap. Like she's swatting a fly. That is so clutch. She actually apologises for that. And a timeout at 12-all. Well, it's such a well-placed forehand. And little to no reaction from Sha Sha. Not getting too carried away emotionally here. Sergio Won trying to save another game point here. Can't help but think back to when she missed that serve at 10-9. Amazing third ball attack. Denying Sha Sha once again. Well, that was the coach's advice. The forehand spin on the pivot. The defender going for the attacking option. Set up well by the serves that Sha Sha pushed due to the surprise factor of the long serve. Ooh!
14-13.
She tries to rip it there, Sha Sha. She knew it was coming to the backhand. But in the blink of an eye, it was there at the back line, pressuring her. And now Sergio Won has the serve at game point. Can she take this and go 2-1 up? Intricate play, blossoming, but wow. Good recovery. For the second time in recent history, she's been taken to the decider by a defender. Don't forget, Han Ying was 2-0 up against her at the Champions Macau, and Sun came back. You have got to be kidding me. Oh, out of all the balls that she missed, it was that one. What a point. Look how Xia Xia's wrapping around the ball with the side spin and then just brings it closer with the block. See how effective the change of pace can be? Doesn't have to be a big shot every time. Some fortune there for Sir. Tell your friends to tune in here. This is really, really fitting the description. She's just stalling here, Xia Xia. Was there a flash in the crowd? Yes, there was. My friend tells me next to me. Another bit of luck. The net making that chop even harder to return. Three, two. Well, well, well. Look at that momentum for Sir. Sir, good. Sorry, that was awful. But no joke for Sun Ying Xia right now. At the first tie break of this ball, she's trailing by two. Beating some top players before the Koreans, such as Fang Chunwei, Hirano Ishikawa. But this would be the best win of her career. And she'd do it at 36 years old. Well, let's not get carried away. This is Sun Ying Xia at the end of the day. She's so mentally stoic. She has such zen and presence at the table. She won't really be thinking about the score right now, just how she needs to play. Well, that time, Sehyuan can't make that kind of guided loop to the forehand side. She's a little bit further away from it this time. Korean coach still on his feet, because it was still a well-played point from the defender, but not enough there. Oh, and that's an escape. Push has to be to that middle section. Then Xia Xia knows Sehyuan's probably not going to make a winner on the third ball. Look how spinny that is. Wow. Xia Xia is doing everything in her power. Look how shallow that ball was. It didn't even look possible from that position. Got it back, sir, but then, yeah. She's not going to miss from there, Xia Xia. She does, you're really questioning the form. Oh, pleasure.
7-4.
All the Chinese coaches are really trying to egg her on. I've got Marlin behind me. We've got Cho Yiko over there, obviously coaching, as well as the physios, the entourage of the Chinese staff. Playing a few pushes initially here, Sun Ying Sha. And that can be a good tactic, just pushing a few, because then that can play in the mind of Sekio on a little bit. She'll be thinking, when is the attack going to come? When it does, she might not be as prepared because of the fact that she's anticipating.
5-8.
Both players have used their timeouts. Fades it, but that was a costly shot. Because that's a risky take when you play the forehand from the backhand. You're leaving it exposed. Sun knew what to do. The momentum now with the shining Sun. 6 of the last 8.
9-6.
Looking likely now to go to a decider, which is just going to be amazing to see as a neutral. Four game points.
6-6.
Solid as a rock, Sun Ying Sha. It just takes a lot, doesn't it, to shake her. Maybe a few demons now in the mind of Sergio Womp. Hao Cho. Piao Lian from Sun Ying Sha. First point to Sun. We know it takes something different, something more unique to beat a world-class Chinese player. A defender fits the description, but still so difficult. The Sun is the hardest hitting slayer in the game. She gets the sky lob and gets over it. 1 foot in the air for that one. Great start for the world number one. Serves with Sergio Wong. Yeah.
Last three.
Good spin. A deep breath from Sir. She's going to have to dig deep. Is the hope draining out of her heart? Put that in your pipe and smoke it. That transfer of weight, watch and learn. All that energy coming straight out in front for a wonderful winner. Flawless start here in game 5.
4-1.
Look like that might be what she needs to win a point. The mood Sha Sha's in right now, Sergio Womp gets a bit of fortune. Virtually unreturnable.
Oh.
into the middle again. This isn't looking good, is it, for the Korean? At the change of ends, she's trailing by four. Who is going to go through to face Jeon Ji-hee in the round of 16? Looking like the champion on screen. Stamps a foot on that push, but stamping her authority on the third ball. You wonder sometimes why these choppers decided to be a defender when they can make attacks like that. But it's the mix, it's the variation. That's what they bring to the table. Can't hide her emotion right now. Just too hot to handle. Sha Sha extends her lead. A cushion of 5 points. Literally in full swing. What really can you do against shots like that? I guess prevention's better than cure, but there's only so many tricks you've got in the bag as a player, and I think Sergio Wan's used them all now. Just knew that it was going to be impending doom when Sha Sha wound back there off a slightly higher chop. Two away from sealing the deal and closing the door on the Korean defender, who's been amazing this match. But it's looking like it's going to be a task too tough. Sun Ying Sha with 7 match points. That was an absolute rip ride of a forehand. Sometimes you play those when you've got your back to the wall like this.
5-10.
Two amazing match point saves. Sha Sha scratching her head. How can I finish this? Well, pressure makes diamonds.